Good evening and welcome to Sunday Sports Rewind and yet another edition of Cheese and Packers. Chris Barrier, Kelly Price, and from The Athletic, our Packers insider, Michael Cohen. And guys, we begin tonight with some news that is as fresh as this wonderful shiny provolone here at the end of our cheese board, and that is something that you broke earlier today, Michael Cohen. A trade in the works. The Packers have acquired from the Indianapolis Colts Antonio Morrison in exchange for Lindsey Pipkins, an inside linebacker for a cornerback. Michael, is this just as simple as supply and demand? Too many of one, not enough of the other?
Yeah, I think that's exactly what it is. You know, with the injury to Jake Ryan a couple of weeks ago, they lost a starter at inside linebacker. Then Oren Burks dislocates his shoulder in pregame warmups at Oakland, and all of a sudden, you're down two of your top three guys. I think it was a matter of wanting to get more experience, so they go out and get a guy that started 15 games for the Colts last year, led them in tackles, a guy that has experience, that was a former fourth-round pick, somebody they can count on. And so you expose a guy like Lindsey Pipkins, giving him away, because that's not a position they really need. So you get rid of him and you bring in a guy for essentially nothing, because Pipkins might have been cut anyway by next weekend.
Antonio, a former Gator, and Kelly, you had a chance to cover this guy during your time in Florida. What can you tell us?
I did. About him? I actually covered him from the recruiting stage before he even went to Florida, and then as he was a Gator at Florida. So I've actually known him a pretty long time. But so did Oren Burks, actually. He talked about how he played against him while he was at Vanderbilt and Morrison was at Florida, saying that he got after the Vanderbilt quarterback a couple times. So that's maybe something that he will bring to the Packers. Was sixth among the NFL inside linebackers last season in tackles. He led the Colts. He's kind of a guy that finds the ball, he'll stuff the run, and he's a sure tackler. But with that, he also has an interesting personality. He kind of had some disciplinary issues. He's a guy that will talk to you. He's gonna maybe say a couple things after he makes a tackle. But that gritty mentality might be something that matches up well with Mike Pettine's defense.
And true story, he once barked at a police dog.
This is correct. He was actually arrested for that while at Florida. But going back to Oren Burks, he dislocated his shoulder in pregame warmups Friday in California. We heard from him today at his locker. He doesn't still have a timetable on when he might return. But how significant is that injury for this Packers defense?
Well, he and Mike McCarthy said that the results from the MRI were positive. He thinks that he'll be back sooner than later. Whether or not that's week one, we don't know. But it certainly doesn't appear that they're going to lose Burks for the season, which was probably the immediate fear when they saw him go out Friday night.
Guys, I'd like to call your attention to the end of our cheese board here. We have a lovely Swiss cheese, and Swiss cheese is full of holes, very similar to the way the Packers offensive line was on Friday night. Michael, what was going on there, and is that something that we should be concerned about?
Well, when we talked to GM Brian Gutekunst last week, he said the hardest thing to do is to find depth at offensive tackle. There's only so many 6-foot-plus, 300-pound-plus guys that can move agilely enough to play that position. And so when you look at what the Packers have in Kyle Murphy and Jason Spriggs, I just don't know if you can trust either one of those guys. And that was the big issue in Oakland. You had Spriggs playing left tackle, Murphy playing right tackle, and even Byron Bell was having issues up the middle when he was playing guard. So I think right now backup offensive line is a huge area of weakness for the Packers. And if David Bakhtiari or Brian Bulaga, either one of them went out, I just don't know if you have anyone that you can count on right now to get you through a game without potentially injuring Aaron Rodgers in the process.
That being said, the poor offensive line play also kind of muddled the view that we could take looking at DeShone Kizer and Brett Hundley. So that battle is still evolving. Did we learn anything about them on Friday night?
I think what we've learned at this point is that it's got to be Hundley's job to lose at this point. I just think that with what he's shown in terms of a command of the offense, he's shown better pocket awareness. These are things that he didn't really have last season filling in for Aaron Rodgers. And now all of a sudden, he looks like a guy that has more experience than Kizer, even though Kizer played more games last season. And so I just don't see any scenario where you can say that Kizer is better or has progressed far enough in the system to replace Hundley as the backup to Rodgers. So I fully expect, barring some sort of miraculous game here in the final week, I think it's Hundley that's the backup once again.
We've got one more game before they get real. That's preseason week four in Kansas City Thursday night right here on NBC 26. Michael, what are we watching for that?
I think it's got to be the final few roster battles. You know, there's still some prominent veteran players that have to figure out if they're going to make this team. You know, it certainly seems like Spriggs is fine now, but he was a guy that was on the bubble. But how about Quentin Rollins, another second round pick, a guy that was in the same draft class as Demarius Randall. Randall, of course, is now gone. Rollins has played a bunch of different positions, from corner to slot to inside linebacker to safety. So I really want to see, can he do enough to sneak his way onto this roster with a position change in a contract year?
Michael, always a pleasure to have you in. We'll see you in Kansas City, but until then, please help yourself with some cheese.